sorry if I did something to upset you.
I'm not upset with you, Stuart. I just hate this whole damn situation. And I'm very worried about Liza. She's got herself in this terrible mess, and there's nothing I can do about it.
All the more reason to stay out of it. You're a wonderful mother, Marion. Liza knows she can depend on you if she needs you.
Thank you, Stuart. Do you know that you are the wisest and most honest man in pants? And in kilts, too, for that matter. I absolutely adore you.
I adore you, too.
Uh-oh. Do you realize this is the second day in a row we've had a tiff?
Oh, that wasn't really a tiff.
Oh, darling, please, can't it be a tiff?
You want it to be a tiff?
Oh, yes. Because, you know, once we have an argument, we have to kiss and make up. Don't we, my darling?
Oh, yeah. Oh, that was definitely a tiff.
Oh, good.
Oh. Joe, excuse me. I was looking for Jake. Have you seen him?
Is this about Liza's baby?
Well, that was a very unfortunate turn of events last night. And I've just been thinking about Jake. He's such a young man. He's still staking his claim on the world. He doesn't really need to be burdened with worrying about a child.
Oh, wonderfully thoughtful of you, Adam, to be so concerned about Jake.
Joe, I've changed a lot this past year because of Liza. I'll be a good parent to that baby.
This is for Liza and Jake to decide. He's with her now to get this thing settled.
Settling how?
Well, if there's an easy way, let's hear it.
All right. You sign an affidavit that says I'm the legal father. Trevor will register it with the court and put my name on the birth certificate. That way, if something happens to you, nobody can dispute the paternity.
Do you realize what you're asking of me? If anything happened to me, I would want Adam to be the father of this child. I want him to be her father. This is not your decision. This is not your child. Please, we are friends. Please don't go down this road.
I know we are friends, and I value that very much. But my concern has got to be with the child.
And what if I say no?
Then it gets nasty. I'll have to file a paternity suit, Liza. We'll let the blood work do all the talking. Court will decide who the father is and what his rights are.
This confession of yours makes no sense.
Why is it so hard for you to understand? I don't want help. I don't want your help. I don't want anybody else's help.
Does that include Braden's help?
This isn't about me, and this isn't about Braden. This is about you, the guy who's always right, except when he's wrong. I confessed because I'm guilty.
I don't believe you.
Because you don't want to believe me. Because you look at me and you see yourself years ago when Kit accused you of rape and made you the victim. Well, guess what, Dad? This time, she's the victim. And you've been had. Again. Life doesn't make sense. Maybe it never will. Get over it.
And Braden Spartanus would be what?
He's just an old friend who got caught up in it like everybody else. Nothing else to it.
I guess that's it. Okay. You're right, kid. Congratulations. You got me. Good luck in prison, Ryan. And, good luck with the acting thing.
Thank you. The woman was never raped. But since she's already convinced the cops, the DA, and probably the judge that she was, well, why would the guy from the parking lot ever step forward, huh?
What makes you so sure she wasn't raped?
Ryan told me that they never found any evidence that she was forced. There were no bruises, no signs of violence. It was consensual sex.
Then you should come forward and say that.
But since Ryan has already confessed, there's no reason for this guy to ever step forward, right? You'll never find him. I mean, he's covered his tracks. He's long gone. He's disappeared. Do yourselves a favor. Just give it up.
Well, I have to think about it, won't I?
Oh, okay. Okay.
Jake. If I signed an agreement that stipulated that you were the biological father, you know, in case of an emergency or whatever, would you be satisfied and leave us alone?
I can't do that. It's more than just the name on the birth certificate. Liza, I want to be a real father to her.
Hey, six-pack, you want lunch or not?
No, I'm not hungry.
Suit yourself. It's a long time till dinner, though.
Yeah, all right, I'll have some. What's your name, anyway?
Call me Charlie. But don't be figuring on striking up no friendship. Your sentencing's scheduled for next week, and after that, you're on your way to Statesville.
Hey, what did you find out?
Did you talk to Ryan about Braden?
Yeah, I found out that Ryan is a fairly good actor, that Braden is nothing but an innocent, long-lost friend, and that we are all just victims of some cruel, lavery hoax.
So he's sticking to his confession?
You buy it?
Not for a minute. Ryan's innocent, and Braden's in this thing up to his neck.
Well, ladies, I'd love to stay and chat, but I better get changed and get back to work before Mr. Cortland gets out of his meeting. I'll be in touch.
Great. He's right about one thing. Any man that would let another man sit in jail for rape, or even if the rape didn't exist, doesn't exactly have a noble streak. It's not likely that the real rapist is going to come forward.
Maybe you're right. I just don't understand why he's so ready to throw in the cloth.
Towel.
I mean, he fought so hard for Ryan. He knows Ryan didn't do it.
Jillian, what exactly do you know about Brayden?
They go way back. I think they were friends. And I get the idea that they've been through some pretty hard times together.
Well, judging from what Ryan's told me about his childhood, there's been plenty of those. Oh my God. This may sound really crazy, but do you think Ryan is protecting Braden?
Oh.
I know what you mean. Do me a favor. Hit me.
Hit you?
Yeah, right here.
Why, you got a screw loose?
Yeah, either that or my head is on backwards. I can't see it and it's driving me crazy. Why would Lavery confess to a crime he didn't commit, especially a crime like rape? Can't figure it.
Well, maybe you're not supposed to figure it.
Maybe it can't be figured. Maybe I'm the factor that doesn't fit in.
Don't feel guilty. I mean, you had nothing to do with what happened between them.
I've been acting like I did. I've been running around town like I'm the resident Kit Fisher expert. Maybe Ryan's right. Maybe I'm the one that can't accept reality.
Now, look, you are the resident Kit Fisher expert. Nobody in town knows as much about her as you do.
A lot of years ago, Dixie. Long time. Maybe she has changed. Maybe Ryan is guilty.
But he isn't.
Why would he take the rap?
I got a hunch. That's why I'm here.
You know why Ryan confessed?
No. But I think you do.
Hi, Ryan.
You here cloaked?
I can hardly afford to do that.
So then what, just came to see the evil rapist in the clink? Make sure Kit and the rest of womankind are safe from my clutches. Well, don't worry, they're out there. And I'm in here. Your job's done, you can go. Are you waiting for a jailhouse brawl? What do you want?
I don't know. Maybe I can offer some help.
My, my. What have we here? A little secret from Mumsy?
What the hell are you doing in my room?
You want to be the father of our child?
She's not your kid.
The hell she is.
Look, Liza and I will raise this child. We will be her parents, her only parents.
You have no right to keep me away from my daughter. I am her biological father, and I intend to be her real father.
So, what'd you think? Ooh, I still have the touch. Bye-bye.
You know, I'm actually beginning to enjoy this.
It's been nice getting to know you.